Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, we're going to run through everything you need to know about the liability recognition and measurement process. We'll start off with a high-level overview to make sure we understand what liabilities are. Next, we'll dive into what it means to recognize a liability in the financial statements. And finally, we'll talk about how to measure and report the value of a liability. We can think of liabilities as financial debts and obligations that a company has committed to settle in the future. Examples include bank loans, wages owed to employees, or payments that are owed to suppliers. All of the company's liabilities are reported on the balance sheet as either current liabilities to be settled within 1 year or long-term liabilities to be paid beyond that 1 year time frame. Understanding how to manage and appropriately account for these liabilities is critical to the financial health of an organization. Maybe you have some of your own personal debts or liabilities. Do you happen to have any student loans that you're currently working on paying off? Funds that you owe to the bank for your home or car are also common examples of personal liabilities. Businesses take on these same kinds of debt in order to continue to operate and grow, and they're required to report the value of these liabilities within their financial statements. This is why it's so important that we understand how to account for these types of liabilities. Before we go any further, the first step is to understand the concept of liability recognition. The liability recognition process helps us determine when we're required to recognize a liability on the company's balance sheet. In order to do so, it must meet a set of specific criteria set out in the accounting standards. Let's bring them up on the screen. According to the accounting standards, a liability is recognized when it's probable that there will be an economic outflow of resources in the future and that this outflow can be measured reliably. The outflow of resources must have resulted from a past event, and it occurs as a result of settling a present legal obligation. To understand this a little better, let's look at an example of a company that needs some extra funds to fill an inventory order. So they go to the bank and they borrow $100,000 on a 4-year loan. Now, the bank doesn't just give out these loans for free, so they've also included a 10% interest rate. Let's first check the criteria to see if this meets the recognition requirements for a liability. Number one, do we have a present legal obligation here? Well, in this case, in order to obtain a loan from a bank, they would have required the company to sign a contract, otherwise known as a note payable, in order to release the funds. As soon as the company signs that document and receives the funds, a legal obligation to pay this back in the future has taken place, and therefore we have met this criteria. Number two, did this come about as a result of a past event? This is really just confirming that the transaction has already taken place. In this case, again, the criteria is met because the loan has already been executed and the money has changed hands. Number three, and possibly the most important criteria, is whether there is expected to be a future economic outflow that can be measured reliably. What this really means is, did the transaction result in a situation where the company will be required to make future payments? And can we accurately put a dollar amount to the debt? Again, in this case, the answer is clearly yes. We know the specific dollar amount that needs to be paid back. In this case, it's the $100,000 principal plus 10% interest per year. And we also know the specified time frame of 4 years. From this analysis, it appears that this $100,000 expenditure meets all of the required criteria to be recognized as a liability on the balance sheet. This $100,000 would be the initial measurement of the liability, which we'll discuss a little bit more later. The accounting entry would be an increase or debit to the company's cash for $100,000 that they received, with a corresponding increase of $100,000 or credit to the company's notes payable liability. The portion due back within the current year, such as the current year's interest, would be reported as a current liability, and the remainder would be listed as a long-term liability. Why is it so important that this information be recorded on the company's balance sheet? Well, this communicates to other external users of the company, such as investors or creditors, that the company has committed to paying these funds in the future. Now that we have a good understanding of how to recognize a liability, let's run through a few common misconceptions. Some people hold the belief that all liabilities and debts are a bad thing. However, this is not necessarily the case, especially when it comes to companies that are in the growth phase and are looking to access capital in order to make investments that will allow them to hire more people and expand the business. Where it does become challenging is when companies take on too many liabilities and don't have the ability to pay them back when they come due. Not all liabilities come with a signature and a contract, like the bank loan example from earlier. Sometimes we have liabilities arise, such as potential lawsuits, where the future obligation is not a 100% certainty. In these types of situations, we still have to apply the criteria, and it's based on what we know today. We take a look to see if it appears that there is a high likelihood that there will be a legal obligation in the future, then the liability would still need to be recognized. In the case of a lawsuit, we would likely seek legal advice to get a professional opinion on the matter. So now that we understand how to recognize the liability, the next question is, how do we measure the value of the liability? Again, there are accounting rules and guidelines that help us determine what to report as the liability value in the company's balance sheet. Let's go back to the earlier example where the company took out a $100,000 four-year loan on a 10% interest rate. Let's assume that they're required to pay interest annually and make installment payments of $25,000 per year on the principal balance. As we discussed earlier, the initial measurement at the time we first take out the loan would be that $100,000 liability. However, as the years pass, the company will be recognizing all the interest that is accruing and making the installment payments to the bank. The reason this is important is because each year that the company produces financial statements over the 4 years, they'll need to remeasure the liability to reflect the updated amount owing. For example, if we keep the interest out of this for now, at the end of year two, the company would have made two installment payments of $25,000 each for a total of $50,000. If we take the original $100,000 and subtract out the $50,000 that has now been paid back, that brings us to a new liability measurement of $50,000. This is the amount left on the loan and the number that we would report as the value of the liability on the company's updated balance sheet at that time. And that brings us to the end of the video. Remember, the majority of companies enter into arrangements in the normal course of business that result in liabilities that need to be recorded in their financial statements. For that reason, it's important that we understand how to both recognize and measure the value of liabilities. The ability to grasp and implement these topics can have a significant impact on the accuracy of a company's financial report. If you're interested in learning more about financial accounting concepts like this, please feel free to check out our additional videos for many more related concepts.